there's no doubt in my mind that this is a match made in heaven. He treats her like gold. His unconditional love both ways. They're perfect for each other, and I'm sure there's not one person in this room that would question that. They're going to have an amazing marriage. I'm so proud to call you son-in-law, and I look forward to a lot of great memories. Cheers.
Within your marriage, you would show to one another and to those looking in something of the gospel. Within Christian marriage, God wants there to be reconciliation. He wants there to be grace. He wants there to be forgiveness. He wants there to be mercy. And when those things are evident and those things are at work in your marriage, that's a picture of the gospel. If I had you, babe.
Amy, it's been 6 years now. Today I've been shaking all day, and just in anticipation of how beautiful you're going to be. It's going to be something I'll remember forever, and I just can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you. So hurry up and get here.
The goal of marriage cannot just be to have a good marriage, because that would be a relative thought. Well, a good marriage to some would be I get to watch ESPN all I want. So there's got to be more. You like ESPN? Okay. I do too, so let's leave that one out of it, okay? Watch all the ESPN you want.
Hi Coleman, it's finally here. You've been my constant love and support, and I can't wait to see where we both are in 30, 40, 50 years. And then I just can't wait to see you. You can finally see my dress too. I love you.
Oh, that looks great.
I love it.
Like, it is amazing.
You're making me happy.
Thank you so much for all your hard work.
Now we were both in the same place.
Oh my god, you look so good, Amy. Like,
you look so good.
My heart ticking like a bomb in a birdcage. Left before someone got hurt.
Clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience.
Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. I love you guys. Amen.
Everything together. Your back and your rope are on that.
All right. You ready to get married?
Yeah. Let's do it.
This is the starting of my great...
Coleman and Amy, your love for each other, which brings you here today, didn't just happen.
I'm all packed up, getting out of here.
God has brought you together. It is just as though you planted a garden, cared for it, and are now reaping its produce. As you continue to grow and cultivate your love for one another, it will experience change and hopefully only get deeper and stronger as time goes on by the grace of God.
This is the starting of a brand new day.
For all the books and preaching and counseling and psychological knowledge, for all of our new ideals and freedom and our emphasis on personal growth and fulfillment, marriage is still basically two people trying to meet the needs of one another. Gives this woman to this man in marriage?
Her mother and I do.
You two have been nurturing your love and relationship that God has called you to. You've created an atmosphere in which your feelings for each other can thrive and continue to grow. Please turn and face each other and continue to hold hands. Coleman and Amy, no other human ties are more tender. No other vows are more sacred than these you are about to assume. You are entering into that holy estate, which is the deepest mystery of experience. The circle of the ring is a perfect circle with no beginning or end.
Taste of Jesus.
still don't know. Coleman, you may now kiss your bride.
In her.
Husband and wife, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to present to you for the very first time Coleman and Amy Bessert.
It's my mouth that must be lying.
We are going to roast Coleman a little bit tonight, and I don't want to miss anything. I honestly can't believe this is actually happening. Father of the bride, I'm way too young.
To all her friends, cold shoulders, sweat, she pretends. I buy Americano every morning, rings me up the wings.
All right, Coleman, this is it. I can't believe it's been 6 years, and I'm sure glad that you bumped into Amy at the Mud football game. I also remember the bear hug at the engagement party. If he offers you a bear hug, decline, because you're gonna get hurt.
You keep driving me crazy, gonna get there, singing. She got the money and I got some money to buy her a big bouquet. She got.
On a more serious note, he is a great kid. We are so thrilled that he's joining the family. He's always got a smile on his face. He's always willing to help. I love his belly laugh, and we're gonna have a lot of laughs.
She keeps walking away into the beginning. To the beginning.
For as long as I can remember, I've looked up to my big sister and wanted to be just like her. I think of Amy as my best friend and role model. She is extremely selfless and she always puts others before herself.
I walk up, she's turning real red now. Deep breath, hi.
I've never seen Amy more happy than when she's with Coleman. He couldn't be more perfect for our family and most importantly for Amy.
We're gonna get there, singing. She got the honey and I got some money to buy her a big bouquet. She got the love and leaves me with nothing, I just don't know what to say. Will I text, steal, and borrow? Tomorrow she'd stay. She got the honey and don't think it's funny that she keeps on.
Amy, he's always gonna be there for you. And the other thing is, he can take a bad time, turn it into a good time.
I come crashing.
You can take a good time, turn it into a great time.
Get there, singing. She got the money and I got some money to buy her a big bouquet. She got the love and leaves me with nothing, I just don't know what to say. Will I text, steal, and borrow? Tomorrow she's.
And I'm excited because, Amy, you guys have something great. I can only imagine how amazing it's going to be.
We're gonna